Here's something you've never heard before. Fender has released a new jazz bass, the American Professional 2, and it's actually really good, so let's check it out! Hi, my name is Gregor, our bass player for today is René Flexenhaar, and Happy New Year! Last summer I walked into a music shop and ended up buying a Mexican-made Fender P-Bass because I fell in love with it and it's just really, really good. A few months later, Fender got in touch with me and asked if I'm interested in reviewing their American Professional 2 series, which of course I am, no question about that. And I chose this Dark Knight model because it looked amazing, kind of mysterious on the picture. However, in real life, a lot more disco, but I'm over it now. It looks cool. It feels like a blend between a vintage jazz bass and one of those modern active ones. It's passive though, and in many other ways also true to the originals. We have an alto body and a maple neck and a maple fretboard with a 9.5 inch radius. I'm a bit surprised they didn't go for a compound radius here, but however, the neck feels great. The edges are nice and round. It's a slim C-shaped neck according to Fender, but I think it actually got some nice meat to it. So what makes this bass so professional? Well, it's actually a number of things. First of all, it sounds really good and very even across the fingerboard, which is crucial to professionals. The high mass, but also a little bit vintage pitch, allows to go the strings through the regular way, but also go through the body, which adds a little bit of sustain. The tuners go incredibly smooth and the adjustment of the truss rod is as easy as it gets. Everything about this bass just feels right. I consider myself a professional and I would actually play this bass, which should tell you everything. However, it also comes with an absolute badass case. And good news if you like the upper frets, the new neck heel gives you great and comfortable access. The pickups are sitting in classical 60s jazz bass positions. They do their job well, but I think the pickups are actually the thing where Fender could have done a little bit better. When I play this bass dry, I think it delivers a little bit more low end than what the pickups put out, and I think they emphasize the highs also a little bit. But don't get me wrong, it still sounds great, and this is nothing that can't be readjusted just with a little turn of the EQ on your amp. I've played this bass extensively over the last weeks and I'm truly impressed. It just feels right. I like the substantial tone and it's just a really, really good bass. The pickups are a little bummer, but I guess we are just entering the world of model and series politics here. Fender has a lot of different series and they have to separate them from each other, and if they put super, super awesome pickups in here, I guess, it's just my guess, that this bass would just be too good and maybe would interfere with their custom shop lines, which they of course also still want to sell. However, if you buy one of those basses, which is understandable because they're great, you can of course put any kind of replacement pickups in there at any time. There are some great replacement pickup manufacturers out there, and I really wonder what it would sound like if one of those put those pickups in there. But I guess we will never find out. Unless maybe we will, because it might actually be the case that these aren't Fender pickups anymore. Of course, you heard Fender pickups in this video, but there might be another videos in the next week where we explore the space in a slightly different way, so maybe stay tuned for that. Fender, great job! This bass alone is proof that this old company is still as relevant as ever. This is a very competitive bass with some great features on its side and a bulletproof case. With this line, and of course they also make P-basses, check those out, I think Fender has created a very interesting series that even all the snobbish boutique bass builders can look up to. quality, it's just a product that works in itself, and I'm just super happy about it. So if you're interested, if I could spark some interest in you, just check it out. And otherwise, I guess, don't. And see you next time. Bye-bye.